The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au. Welcome to the Oz 10-Pin Lanes at Chirnside Park in Melbourne, Victoria for the running of the Sweps Melbourne 10-Pin Cup. Here is your presenter, Janet Baker.
We're at the women's final stage and the stepladder final is about to commence with today's match with Dena Buxton from Victoria came in number 4 and Ann-Maree Putney from New South Wales in number 3. So sit back and enjoy some of the action.
Thank you very much, Jeanette, and welcome to all our viewers to this week's edition of the 10-Pin Bowling Show. We're covering the 2011 Sweps Melbourne 10-Pin Cup Women's Division between bowler number 4 and bowler number 3. We have bowler number 4, Ann-Maree Putney from New South Wales. She's the Women's World Champion from a couple of years back. Very, very determined bowler in her own right. Welcome Brenton Davey, who joins me in the commentary booth.
Thank you, Michael. And first off, you see Ann-Maree got the ball a little bit too wide here. You'll see a couple of marks at the 40 and 45 foot mark. Got to get the ball in between those of the break point, otherwise that's what you're going to leave. Condition this week was very, very, very tight. Even the power players had the sanding pads out looking for dull finish bowling balls.
Well, that would have been a sight to see.
Most certainly was. Ann-Maree not quite getting the ball far enough to the left on the spare conversion attempt. Starts with an open frame.
AMP, after qualifying, finished second with an average of 214.78, and after match play, dropped down to third. Now, the player you see on screen now, Dena Buxton from Victoria, finished the first round of qualifying with a 214.89 average. In first position and after match play, dropped down to fourth.
Dena too, again, that was just that little bit wide. You saw the ball was a couple of boards outside of that second marker that I was referring to. Ball gets out there, has no chance to recover the pocket. You saw hundreds, literally hundreds of washouts this week. It was just probably the most common leave of the week. Tough, tough oiling pattern.
Taking three on the second attempt, and both girls start with a 9 count. Dena Buxton's debut on the 10-pin bowling show.
A little bit of a stick there on the spare attempt. Not going to help your confidence greatly. Ann-Maree now up in her second frame, title line. There's the result.
Straight down and into the pocket, meets the 1-3, nice and flush, does enough to kick out the 5, shreds the rack for all 10.
Dena Buxton has represented Australia in the past. She took quite a time off to raise a family, recently come back, and has been doing so quite successfully. Much better shot there again. In that area between 10 and 15 board at the break point. Nicely balanced at the line. Good long follow through. That shot certainly helped her confidence. That was not too bad at all.
Very, very good. It was a confident, not too shabby pocket hit. Leaves a 4-pin, but like you said, Brenton does have some nice form at the foul line and follows through nice and strongly. Solid spare, and we're 19 apiece.
It's all square through two frames. It was very, very hard this week to freewheel your shot, but it was extremely important that you did. You had to be clean out of the ball, make a nice clean release. You didn't have to hook it a lot, and you didn't want to hook it a lot. Condition certainly didn't allow, but if you're nice and clean out of the ball, good things happened with the carry.
Oh, there's a little bit of hook down the back end. Nice carrying all 10 here. Five pin well taken care of. 10 pin slapped out of there.
The carry, realistically, wasn't particularly difficult this week. If you kept the ball nice and tight and you're nice and clean out of the ball, the carry was actually very good.
Going Brooklyn side. Leaving the nine.
And Dena's first appearance on TV. She's looking a little bit tight, I think. Needs to loosen up. She's up against a quality opponent who you see in the background there is looking very relaxed. She's been here many, many times before. Oh, dear. Whoa.
Missed that one a long way left.
Yeah, I think the nerves first time on TV might be on the attack here. Dena's dug herself a very early hole here, 37 in the third frame. Ann-Maree Putney working on a double. Throws a strike here, and yeah, this match is close to being put away early.
Wow.
Which would be unfortunate, but it happens sometimes in bowling.
See what Ann-Maree can do, working on a double. Good confident throw. Well, couldn't quite get the mix for the 7-pin carry.
Was a confident throw, but I think you just amped up the ball speed a little bit, and the consistency of the ball speed was really critical this week. Quite often the difference between carrying and not carrying.
So the lock about Ann-Marie's shot at the moment is that she's still freewheeling through the swing and still throwing it with a fair bit of power, but she's angled the ball into the pocket so that...
Whoa!
Wow, that was close. So that when the ball meets the pocket, the ball has still retained a fair bit of energy and can really throw the pins around.
That's right. There was no problem with the ball losing energy by hooking too early this week. Did not see that happen once. There were a few times where the ball didn't hook early enough, therefore hit weak. A little bit later in the show, I'll be doing a description of the oiling pattern, which we taped a little bit earlier, and just to give you an idea what the players are up against. Dena Buxton now needs to start striking.
Oh, nice pocket hit. Wrapped at 10. Trying to get a little bit more straighter and direct into the pocket. And this was a good shot. Nice and flush.
Just maybe just a little too much side roll. The hard part this week was staying behind the ball. Given the volume of oil that was out there, you give it, throw two or three shots where you stayed behind the ball. It was hard not to sort of find yourself just helping the ball up a little bit. And as soon as you did that, if you hit the pocket, basically you tended to wrap like that. Good spare. And Dena, the good solid spare there. That'll help her confidence.
Let's go down to Jeanette.
Okay, Ann-Maree, bit of a slow start, but you look like you found your line now.
Oh, I hope so.
They look fairly oily.
Yeah, they are pretty oily, pretty straight, like an arrow, so we're just going to try and persevere with the same shot.
Good luck for the rest of the game.
Thank you.
The lane condition for the 2011 Melbourne Cup here at Oz 10 Pin Chernside is a 44-foot WTBA London pattern. Kneeling down here, we see these marker boards at the 40 and 45-foot mark. You'll notice during the show that every bowler will be attempting to put their ball through this area. If they get the ball outside of this particular marker here, the ball will generally skid too long and not recover back to the pocket. However, and this has been the key to this week's tournament, the inside board there, which I'm pointing at, if the bowler's missed a board, maybe two boards inside that, there's enough oil there to hold the ball on line and still hit the pocket. The other big story from this weekend has been sanding pads. Because of the extreme heavy oil of this pattern,
that bowlers from Australia have been saying is the heaviest they've ever seen, been sanding their bowling balls with abrasive pads, anything up to 180 grit. Normally this much sanding would wreck a lane pattern, but there's this that much oil on this particular pattern. It's held up really well for the week, and in fact, with all the sanded bowling balls that have been bowled here, the power players are making use of the track being carved in the lane.
And welcome back to the Tenpin Bowling Show's continuing coverage of the Schweppes 2011 Melbourne Tenpin Cup. The ladies' division, it's Ann-Maree Putney from New South Wales versus Dena Buxton of Victoria. Ann-Maree carrying a 21-pin lead after the fourth.
That's going to be close. Again, what I was talking about in that little segment on the lane condition, saw the ball rolling directly between those two marks.
That was the flushest pocket hit of the game so far.
Now it's down to Jeanette with Dena.
Okay, Dena, it's been a while since you've been in this arena. How's it feeling?
Yeah, a bit nervous, but it's been a long time, but I'm glad I'm here.
Your shot's looking good. You just got to settle into the game, right?
Yes, definitely, most so.
Good luck for the rest.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jeanette. And for information on the Tenpin Bowling Show, please visit our website, www.tenpinbowlingshow.com.au. We join coverage again with Dena Buxton taking her fifth frame. And let's hope she can strike, because Ann-Maree Putney is just slowly pulling away.
That she is. Needs to get something happening pretty quickly. There's graphic there again, what I was discussing with the lane condition. Ball rolling through the 12th or 13th board between those two markers. Ball got the break point just in the right place. 10 in the pit, and that's what you had to do all week, strokers and power players alike.
Big smile on Dena's face. It's a smile of relief, I think, getting the first strike out the way. Well done.
Is, and for all her trials and tribulations, she's only 21 pins behind. Certainly far from out of it.
And Maria at the top of the sixth. She's well and truly found her strike. Just outside that 45-foot marker, but doing enough to carry.
Yeah, because she's angling the ball slightly towards the pocket, basically she hit pretty much that particular dark board that I was talking about. Had she been a board wider of that, she'd have had next to no chance to strike. Dena Buxton now looking to build on that strike. Needs to build on the strike because Ann-Maree has a double. Can get a strike here. She stays within 21 pins and well and truly still in the match. Oh, just a hair high.
It's the correct line. And as you see, the ball creeping just that tad high, and as a result, leaving the four pin.
No matter what happens in this match, I think we're going to see a lot more of Dena on the 10-pin bowling show in future editions. He's got a good, strong game, very solid at the line, and throws a nice rotation. So I think we'll certainly be seeing plenty of her, irrespective of what happens in this match.
Very similar to AMP in a lot of ways. It's very solid at the foul line and throws it with everything she's got. And there's another flush pocket hit for Ann-Maree Putney. Puts three together.
This is a weekend where you did not give the pocket away. Even some of the best players best power players this country's ever produced weren't giving the pocket away all weekend. It was just, you know, keep it in really tight, play percentages. Because the carry, and even though we are playing a very tight line, the carry was extremely good from that angle. Dena now really needs to get back on the strike train. Otherwise, she's going to start needing help from Ann-Maree, and Ann-Maree doesn't look like giving it to her.
Oh, no, she won't give up a bit.
Just that hair wide. just that hair wide. You know, I reckon that hit, that's hit about 8 or 9 board. And just from out there, it just goes that little bit too long. And you think, you know, 5 boards hit at 45 feet. Well, when you're swinging a 15-pound bowling ball and putting a type of spin rotation on it and having to keep your speed consistent, not that easy to do.
It's a lot to do at the same time, isn't it? Mind you, you're hitting a mark down the other side of the lane 40 feet away with it's probably about the width of a 50-cent piece. It's not much to go on.
Not much to go on at all, and just given the type of averages that were thrown this week, the bowlers adjusted to the condition very, very quickly.
Kind of helped that if you miss inside, it's going to give you a bit of forgiveness, but...
There was a couple of boards forgiveness inside. Didn't need the forgiveness there. That's a great shot.
Yeah, fantastic shot. Well and truly right in the pocket now.
And the main thing that helped this pattern play the way it did too was that this is basically a brand new bowling thing. It's only about 7-8 months old. So the lanes haven't had a chance to sort of have any kind of track areas bedded into it. The condition played very, very true.
Oh, nice piece of carry there from Dena. She'll take some heart from that. And with 2 frames to go, she's a fair way out of the contest.
Going to need some help. Here's Jeanette now talking with Ann-Maree.
Well, Ann-Maree, you're looking really comfortable now. You're going to finish out the game strong.
I hope so. I feel like bowling a bit slower, so I'm happy with it.
Your timing looks really good.
About time.
Yeah, well done. Good luck.
Welcome to the conclusion of this week's edition of the 10-Pin Bowling Show, covering the Schweppes 2011 Melbourne 10-Pin Cup. Ann-Maree now looking to step up her game and finish out. Another pocket hit. Oh! Not quite getting the job done on the 7-pin.
Not quite getting the job done on the 7-pin. A strike there was a shutout. If she were to go and go open... in these last 2 frames and Dena was to strike out, Dena would actually win by a pin.
Likely scenario?
Not likely.
And that quells all chances of that happening. And Marie, all she needs is any kind of mark in the 10th and she will win.
And there's Jeanette talking with Dena.
Well, Dena, a little bit of luck and the game could be a lot closer. A couple of 9 counts that could have been strikes. But we're still looking good.
We are. If I can sort of bag out, we could make a go of it. But
good luck.
And the very best of luck to Dena as she steps up and tries to complete her game. Strike off the sheet here gives her a game of 205. And Ann-Maree would only...
have to turn up, basically. Oh, that one's a bit inside.
And not quite turning away to make the Brooklyn pocket. She's left the baby split, the 310.
There were very, very few Brooklyns this week, strangely enough, on such a tight pattern. You know, there were a couple of boards of hold in around 15 board. He had to miss a long way to actually get a Brooklyn. And unfortunately, the wheels have just kind of fallen off here a little bit for Dena. Disappointing for her first TV appearance, but given the way she's performed this week, I have no doubt we'll see a lot more of her.
Ann-Maree effectively winning on the bench.
She's going to want to go out and throw good shots because she's going to have to come back next week against our defending champion, Bianca Flanagan. And we all know how tough she was last year.
Yes, B, very good bowler. She's like Ann-Maree, a multi-Australian representative.
Yeah, just that, a hair light on that one. Had half a chance to strike, but again, ball got around that 10 board. Any wider than that, could have left any sort of ugly combination. That's just the way they played this week. There was a very, very specific way you had to play the condition, and if you didn't, you just didn't score.
Seven pin, her last two attempts, Ann-Maree Putney, but spared them both. And she's going to finish with a very nice 220 game.
New strike for 226. So that's above her average for the week, so you've got to be happy with that.
Oh, can't complain with that. Absolutely not.
You're just making a little bit of a statement to upcoming opponents.
Throwing above average on TV. Well, you definitely can't
argue with that.
There's a 10 pin to finish. Ann-Maree Putney shoots a 225. Very, very good score. And she successfully gets through round one of the step ladder finals.
Now her thoughts will be turning to next week's match.
Oh yes, Bianca Flanagan. Wow.
That one should be a blinder.
An absolute ripper, folks. Be right here next week to see that match.
Dena Buxton now just finishing out. Oh yeah, that's a little bit on the wide side. And as I said, we saw literally hundreds of those during the tournament this week. I left 15 of them myself, I reckon. Yes, I did bowl this week. Well, I at least attempted to bowl.
That's not what most bowlers would call
languishing,
bowling.
languishing midfield.
You're just holding up the top 16.
Yeah, if you can call 38 holding up the top 16, yeah, for sure. Had a run at it. Oh, a little bit too far.
And that's the one that hooked away. Dena Buxton finishing with a 150. It's not quite enough for Ann-Maree Putney's 225.
Well, commiserations, Dena. You gave it a good shot after so many years out of the arena. Is that going to motivate you to come back again?
It is, most definitely. Yep.
And it's my pleasure to award you with fourth place for this year's 2011 Schweppes Melbourne Tenpin Cup. Well bowled. Excellent.
Well, there you have it, folks. An exciting match ending with AMP Ann-Maree Putney finishing with a 225 to Dena Buxton's 150. Give us a quick rundown, Brendan.
Well, basically what this match came down to, Michael, was that Ann-Maree kept the ball in the proper track area for pretty much the entire match. She only threw one shot, which was her first frame, outside of that track area, which meant she was in the pocket pretty much the entire time. Dena, a lot of nerves in that particular match. She threw a few shots wide of the mark, also threw a few shots very tight, and she never really settled into a rhythm. But as I said during the telecast, I've got no doubt we'll see her again very soon.
Oh, absolutely. She's a very, very good bowler. And unfortunately for you viewers, you didn't see it this week. But I have no doubt she'll fire up again soon. Now, next week, it's a mouth-watering event there.
Oh, isn't it what? Our defending champion, Bianca Flanagan, who you'll remember from last year, defeated Esther Chia from Malaysia in a two-frame roll-off after the scores were tied at 203 apiece.
Couldn't get any closer than that.
She's shown that she knows how to win this tournament. She is going to be a very, very tough opponent for Ann-Maree Putney. I would not like to try and pick a winner.
Oh, no, I don't think I could either. But can't wait for that one. Thanks very much for joining us, folks. From Brenton, Davey, Michael and all the crew at the Tenpin Bowling Show, goodbye from Chernside.
The 10-Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.